Hare Krishna. The greatest enemy of love is not hatred, but indifference. When a poor person gets a great treasure, then that person protects the treasure zealously and stays away from things or thieves that may steal the treasure. Similarly, when we get the treasure of devotion for Krishna, a treasure that can grant us lasting fulfillment, then we need to stay away from things that can steal away the treasure from us. And the foremost of the things that can steal away the treasure from us is often thought to be the opposite of devotion. Opposite of love normally is hatred. So we normally are warned, and understandably so, that we should avoid the devotion of those who, our association of those who hate Krishna. So those who are aggressive anti-theists, by their venomous anti-devotional propaganda, can damage our faith. And that's why, to protect our treasure of devotion, we stay away from them, and that is good. But along with that, we also need to stay away from a subtler enemy. In fact, the most dangerous enemy of bhakti is not the most visibly anti-devotional one, but it is a subtly non-devotional one. And that is not hatred, but indifference. Why is this more dangerous? Because it does not appear to be such an enemy, such a dangerous enemy. And that's what makes it dangerous, No, and anti-devotional propaganda like those of the atheists will make us stop devotional activities. And that will jar us, we'll realize I'm falling into illusion. But indifference makes us not stop devotional activities, but simply stop putting our hearts in devotional activities. Now we start doing those devotional activities such as chanting, praying, worshipping. We start doing those mechanically. And when we start doing them mechanically, then we don't get any higher taste in doing those activities, because the taste in those activities comes from the contact of the soul with Krishna. When we don't connect with Krishna, or when we do mechanical activities, then we don't put our heart in those devotional activities, then Krishna, who manifests through those devotional activities and connects with us and gives us the opportunity to connect with Him, that manifestation of Krishna, we miss that manifestation. And because we don't get a higher taste, we start finding the devotional activities boring. And if day after day we continue devotional activities ritualistically, then we start feeling them not just as a boredom, but as a burden. We start feeling them as a fetter, as a prison that we need to break free from. And to break free from this prison, we often end up doing devotion, we often end up doing activities that are, we often end up feeling that if I could just give up those devotional activities, then I'll be free. There are so many other more important things to do in life, and I'll be able to do them if I just give up these devotional activities. So in the end, if we see, we end up with the same belief as the anti-devotional atheists have, that religious activities are restrictive and giving up those religious activities is the way to freedom. So the same result that the overt enemy of devotion, atheism, can have, hatred of God can have, that same result or the same conclusion, the covert enemy of devotion, that is indifference, can lead us to. And that's why we need to guard vigorously against indifference also. Guard diligently against indifference, vigilantly. So now the Bhagavad Gita pertinently states that Vigata Jvaraha. In 3.30 it says, Mai Sarvani Karvani Sanyasya Adhyatma Chetasa Nirashir Nirmamo Bhutva Yudhyasva Vigata Jvaraha Mai Sarvani Karmani. By offering the fruits of all your work to me, Sanyasya. Renouncing the fruits of work like that. Adhyatma Chetasa. By staying in spiritual consciousness. Nirashir Nirmama Bhutva. Giving up possessiveness and giving up infatuation with desires. Yudhyasva fight, vigata jvaraha. Giving up lethargy, vigata jvaraha. So it's a very resonant, forceful thing Krishna is telling. Vigata jvaraha. Give up lethargy. Now when we give up lethargy and practice devotional service wholeheartedly, then we start getting taste in bhakti. And the more we get taste in bhakti, the more we go beyond the trap of illusions and attain everlasting happiness. Thank you.